Okay, again, today we're going to start lying on the ground again. Great place to start. And we can just do a nice little stretch. Once we get here, you're going to be laying on your back for just a second to get a stretch, but then we're going to roll over onto your front. And then you can get another nice stretch here, maybe reaching up over your head. Maybe off to the side, just whatever feels good, getting a good stretch. And you can maybe even try to grab your heels, stretch your quads out a little bit, and take some deep breaths. Palms up, and you're going to swoop your arms around and finish with them above your low back, palms up. And your head can be resting on the ground. I'm just kind of pulling mine up so that I can talk to you. And you're going to try to keep your arms just a couple inches off the ground, palms up at the top, palms up at the bottom. You can just do a few rotations through that. Continuing with those nice deep breaths. All right, and then we're going to have one palm up, one palm down, and then you'll switch spots. All right, then you're gonna take your hands and just plant them under your shoulders and just like press your chest up and allow your legs to rest on the ground, but your arms to be straight. And you can just kind of like relax in this position a little bit. You're gonna stretch through your lower back. And you can take some nice deep breaths here. Some little raises where you're going to pull your arms can be up over your head, or you can keep them in nice and bent, that's fine, but either way you're going to pull your chest up off the ground and your hips up off the ground, and then you're just going to bring them back down. And again, your arms can be up overhead if you prefer, and just trying to lift as high as you can and then come back down, resting on the ground. All right, and then we're gonna hold in this top position. Get chest up off the ground, trying to get your thighs up off the ground. Really squeezing your glutes. We're gonna hold here for 3, 2, 1, and now we're gonna try to go into like a little rock. And keep rocking, 10 more seconds. Three, two, one. Okay, and then we'll come back up into that. Or sorry, and then we're gonna just keep going into our raises. So back up here, and then relax on the ground. Back up, relax. Thinking about your breath. We're going to hold for 10 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and then we'll rock again. Yeah. and then short breaks as needed, and then keep going. We're gonna rest in 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Here, a little rest. And then you can go ahead and come back into the child's pose. So bending your knees, pushing your butt back to your heels. Kind of getting a stretch now through your back. Here. And you get some nice deep breaths. Next, we're going to come into our plank position. And once you've got into plank, we're just going to walk your hands back to your feet. And you can stand all the way up here if you want, or you can just go right back into that plank for some inchworms. Just some nice, easy paced little inchworms. Standing up feels good after being on the floor for a bit. Next time you come into plank, we'll just hang out here in this plank position, and then you'll take left foot and step it up to your hands, and you can drop that back knee, and then as you sit up, you're going to push your hips forward and lean back, so you get this big stretch through your hips. You can even reach your arms up over your head if you want, and then you'll just bring your hands back down and switch legs. And hips forward, big stretch, and then just switch sides. And then from here, we'll just go ahead and stand up, and we'll do some alternating lunge steps. I like reverse lunge steps, stepping back. And just trying to keep that front knee tracking over your front foot. And just nice, easy pace, alternating lunge steps. And then we're just going to go right back into our inchworms. And so into plank, and then hands back. Walking back out. More seconds for inchworms, and then it's going to be that alternating stretch, the Samson stretch. I don't know why it's called that though. It's been some person who did them. All right, ready, set. Next time you're in this plank, just bring one knee forward, drop the back knee, hips forward, big stretch, and then switch. And then we're going to go into our alternating lunge steps in 3, 2, 1. So any style lunge step that you want. And just alternating at a nice pace. Staying in control, keeping that knee tracking over your foot. Your front foot should stay fully on the ground the whole time. Your chest up. 10 more seconds and we'll do another round, so we'll go back to our inchworms. 3, 2, 1. Inchworms. All 10 more seconds for your inch arms. 3, 2, 1. And we'll do that big, deep lunge stretch. Seconds for these, and then we'll do lunges again. 3, 2, 1, lunges. More seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay, and we'll rest. You can grab a little sip of your water if you want. And okay, next for today. Perfect. We're just gonna go for the rest of the time doing like as many rounds as you like. And your extra goal is to try to get a little bit faster with each set. And so if you have a timer and you want to time yourself with each set, you can do that. But again, it's just kind of like extra. If you don't have a timer or you don't really want to worry about it, you could just try to keep going through rounds. And so it's going to be kind of a little bit of a longer list. We're going to have 5 things that we're going to do, but you're going to do 14 of each thing, so it's kind of easiest to remember how many. And again, modifying as you want, and if you want to just do some, that's totally fine. And hopefully all these movements are straightforward to you, and maybe we can like put them in the chat to help you remember as well. But we're going to start with sit-ups, and if you want to weight these sit-ups, you totally can. We're going to do 14 sit-ups, and if you're going to be weighting them, you just put one weight across your chest. And so a lot of this stuff, you'll have the option to use weights or not. And it's, again, totally up to you, because we're kind of just going to be going on our own through as many rounds as we want. And so, you know, if it's super heavy, maybe you won't get as many rounds as someone who's not using weight. And, like, again, that's totally fine. But it's going to start with sit-ups. And, again, if you want to put the weight across your chest, you can. But either way, you know, you just get your back to the ground, and then you'll sit up. And you can swing your arms. Whatever's great. If you want to put your legs out to the side, like any sit-up is good. Just get your shoulders to the ground and then up to sitting. And again, if you want to weight them, try putting the weight on your chest and keeping it in contact with your body on the way down and on the way up. If you're having a hard time getting up while keeping the weight on your body, you could kind of throw it up a little bit and use it as like a counterbalance, but then keep it on your body on the way down and kind of resist it on the way back down. So then you're at least getting that negative weighted sit-up. So kind of using it as a weight to hoist it up there, but then being in control and on your chest on the way back down. So starting with 14 sit-ups, and then everybody's favorite, push-ups. And so push-ups can go any way you want. You could be in the plank. Try to keep your hips up in line with your chest. Lead with your chest on the way down. Elbows come down and back, and you'll drop your chest to the ground and then press up. That's fine. Or you could come down in a plank and then plant your knees to the floor and then press up. That's great. You could just stay on your knees for all the reps. Also great. You could even go to your box and be on your knees. Love these. Any style of push-up is great. And if you kind of get to failure in one, you can drop down to the others in order to keep moving. That's fine. 14 push-ups. Okay. And then, after your push-ups, you're going to grab your weights if you want, and this is where you're going to use your box, but we're going to like step over it. And so you can step up onto it and then over it, but you're going to try to step over it sideways, so like a lateral step up and then over the other side. And if you had something that you could step over, that would be fine too, but maybe you don't want to step on it, because this is like wobbly and skinny, but it would be okay to just kind of go over it and then come back over it the other way. That'd be fine. So you could modify that way. And you could also just kind of hold on to some weights as you do these, which could make them a little bit more spicy if you want. And so again, 14 of these, and each one counts. So that's one, and then this is two, and then three when I come back over here until we get to 14. And then you're gonna do 14 jumps. So either onto your box, jumping up onto your box and standing, or if you wanna do like a broad jump, or maybe like a tuck jump, but try to catch yourself, or like a squat jump if you want, but we're gonna do some squats next, so you can keep that in mind. But we're gonna do 14 jumps. And then the last one, you'll use your weight, two weights, one weight, whatever, and we'll do a squat plus a press for 14 reps, 14 thrusters. Squat plus press. So 14 sit-ups, 14 push-ups, 14 step-overs, 14 jumps, and then 14 thrusters. And then when you get to the end, you're gonna rest for 2 minutes between each round. So you can totally rest and recover in order to try to like keep up with that initial pace you set, or to try to go like a little bit faster the next round if you can. And so if you have a timer, you can like keep track of that time. I'll also be running my clock. I'm not sure how well you can see it. You can use that. And then you could also, again, just treat it like you're not necessarily trying to go faster each round and just rest when I rest and we'll pick up where you left off. And so you could take your work and rest periods with me if you don't have a timer. And we'll just go for like 30 minutes, 35 minutes, and get as many rounds as we feel like getting. If you get to like so many, if you get to like 5 rounds and you're like, I'm done, I don't want to keep going, and other people are still going, like you can just totally stop and be done, that's fine. But we'll just keep going for 35 minutes until the hour's up. Thumbs up. Cool. Yes. Okay. Love that. I'm going to grab my little pillow for my butt on my sit-ups. If you get butt chafing on your sit-ups, a little pillow can totally help. Even just like a couch cushion or an actual pillow. Okay. I guess let's do it. Okay, so it starts with the sit-ups. 14 sit-ups in 10 seconds. We'll start. 3, 2, 1, go! 14 sit-ups. And then it's push-ups. After your push-ups, it's your step-overs. There. jumps. And we're 3 minutes in. Doing great. Do our squat plus press. Once you finish, you get 2 minutes to rest. So hopefully you got to feel out that first round, and now you kind of know what to expect. We're just going to try to kind of hang out with these movements for another like 30 minutes. I feel like my rest went so fast. I only have like 30 more seconds to rest. I guess that happens. Sit up, push up, step over, jump, squat, press.
push-ups are hard.
I know. Arg. I was thinking the same thing this last set.
I broke them up. I did like 10, and then I took a break, and then I did 4.
Yeah, I know. That I was like, dang, I definitely did these too fast on the first set.
I think I did too many sideways step-ups, because it's one per step up, one step down, right? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's like, over is one, back is two, three, four. That'll give you some buffer time. Great work, everybody. I'm getting sweaty for sure. It's working. Seconds to rest. Arg. 23 minutes in. Getting a good sweat. We've just got about 10 minutes left. A little bit more than 10 minutes. We'll stop the clock at 35. Hopefully right before we get kicked out of our meeting. Hopefully. Maybe time for one more set, depending on where we're at. Mm-hmm. think we have time for another set. And if we get kicked out, sorry, good job, doing great. A nice, slow, steady sweat for today. It's like, I need, we just need like a zone out type workout today. That's what I needed anyway. Not to think too much and just sweat. Oh, yikes. I gotta go in 10 seconds, dang it. Okay, yeah, you can keep going.
Because I didn't weight my step ups.
Yeah.
Then I adjusted my jumps just because my knees are and yeah. It's going to bother me, so.
That's great. No, keep going. We support you.
It will be she instead.
Yeah.
We're going to jump hard.
Totally. That's what's nice. We can all just do our own thing in our space, but be together. Also,
yeah.
In a also not together kind of way. Heidi, are you wearing your Humboldt shirt?
Yeah.
I recognized it.
Tops.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, somehow the one I ended up with is like double XL. And so,
right.
It, yeah, I can't get rid of it though, but it never really makes its way out of the rotation, into the rotation.
Yeah. Mine got used as a painting shirt, so it's a little bit, which was kind of dumb.
Yeah.
But it's still up there.